Hey everyone, welcome to the Berger Creek Homestead. I don't know if you've been following along in our progress as we build our shed house and start our homestead out here, but I want to give sort of an update and also show you what I've been working on today. So first thing first, this is a lived-in house, so sorry it doesn't look show quality here, but here's a sort of an indoor look of what our house looks like right now. As you can see, we've got our butcher block table, we've got some ceiling shiplap done, we've got most of the walls done, everything except our bathroom walls, which we're not going to do in shiplap, we're going to do it in drywall, and we have a lot of stuff done and started and in progress outside as well. We've got meat rabbits, we have three goats now we're going to raise for either probably not for meat but probably for to sell for profit and to use for goat milk. And we've got chickens, and we have one pig this year. And next year we're planning on getting some Dexter cattle, but we need to do some like fence mending and stuff. It's just kind of more a winter project at this point. But we have a lot of stuff that we've been doing. Just yesterday I was putting up shiplap. I finished another section of porch. So I'm doing the porch in 8-foot sections, which I'll show you in a second. But a lot of things going on, a lot of projects, a lot of stuff that's like half done or 3/4 of the way done and not completely there yet. But let me show you around real quick. So the least completed room here is still our guest bathroom / laundry room. So we have our washer and dryer. We have a laundry style sink. And then we have a toilet, which is bolted to the floor but not plumbed in, and then this, there'll be a shower unit in this corner here. Obviously no insulation on the outside wall, which is the only room in the house that's still like that. Most of the kitchen is finished, and I say most because there's still a little bit of wall that needs right here that needs done, but that's it. That's about it. Little like one or two planks on the other side as well. Here's our pantry. Let me step out here so you can actually see it. This is actually kind of difficult to make, believe it or not. A lot of different angles here, but that's where we keep our trash. We've been storing things like our canning pot and our, what's that called? Pressure cooker down there, instant pot, there you go. We've got all our food, most of our food actually, is right here in the pantry. It's pretty deep, so you can put a lot of food there. We've got our children's bedroom in there. Just peek in there. It's really messy. Got a 3-year-old. So still have a lot of ceiling shiplap to finish. But there's our storage loft. It's pretty organized right now, if I can show you the top here. Pretty organized. But not much there. Let me pan around. I'll show you the other loft. Pretty much the same thing going on right now. That is going to be our children's either play space, or we'll make it another bedroom. I'm not sure what. Here we have our mini split, which is keeping our house at around 70 degrees. One complaint I have of that mini split is that it doesn't actually keep it at the temperature that you set it at. So it says it's set at 68. It'll probably keep it around 70, 71. Minor thing, but anyway, here's our bedroom, cleanest room in the house. We have a wall-mounted television in the bedroom with swivel, so we can bring it out and watch in our beds. And we have a sliding door into the bathroom. That was just a homemade door, and it just slides on rollers, just like all sliding doors do. And this is the bathroom. There we go. Now I have a PEX setup, PEX manifold right here that goes to each section of the house. And I don't know if you can read that, but I do have them labeled in my handwriting. so if for example the dishwasher was leaking, or for whatever reason I was replacing it or whatever, I needed to turn it off, just turn this one valve off, everything else in the whole house stays on, which is really nice. Obviously, haven't done the walls in here yet, but that's going to be drywall. Oops. And then got the bathtub like 95% done. Still a little section on the upper left of tile I haven't done yet, but everything else is done. Pretty nice faucet. We really like that. We will eventually have a corner shower also. I think I mentioned that in the guest bathroom, but that bathtub does great for now. Let's go outside. A lot of projects out there. So a lot of stuff laying around. It's a construction site slash 3-year-old's play area. So outside, we've got a porch that extends from over there to right there. So that's about 24 feet. And we'll keep extending. It's got about another 8 foot to the end of the house. And then it's actually going to wrap around to the backside. So a lot of porch here. And then this front side will be covered eventually. Here we've got our garden, which is sort of on its last leg. You know, it's about to be October, so not a whole lot going on left with it. Just Tabasco peppers to pull, and then we're still getting some tomatoes off it. We've got probably about 20 days left before our first frost, and then we won't have anything in there. So not too long left of the growing season. This is what I'm working on today. So we have an issue. We have a skirting issue. We need something. Let me go ahead and situate that here. We're gonna need something for the winter. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna lay skirting down on this entire perimeter of the house by using cinder blocks. And then on the inside of that, I'm just gonna glue poly foam board on the inside of it and lay that in there. And so it'll have a little bit of R value, but more importantly, it'll have wind blockage. And hopefully it does a lot better than last year, which had a lot of issues with cold floor, basically, because I think of the wind coming through. But I'll take you around. There's Penny. Hey, Penny. You're a good girl, aren't you? So this is the next section. So I actually I left this section intentionally because I need to plumb in the shower and the toilet still in the guest bathroom. And I'm going to want an access point anyway for under the house. And so I'm going to make an access point there, and I'm not sure how I'll make it yet. And so I'm just not going to worry about it right now. I'll do it last. And this is the section that I've been working on in the last couple of hours. So I have my first section done. I need some half length cinder blocks right there. And then I'm going to put half thickness cinder blocks up here, which a regular cinder block is 8 by 8 by 16 inches. And so what I'm talking about is I need 8 by 4 by 16 inch cinder blocks right up here at the top. And so that'll tie that in. And then on the sections where it's too much of a gap to leave, but not enough of a gap to the cinder block, I'm going to put some either 2x4s or 2x6 treated lumber to meet the cinder block and tie it into the underside of the house. So hopefully it's going to be completely 100% buttoned up, hopefully in the next couple of weeks or whatever before the real cold starts, because we've already had some 40 to 45-ish degree weather at nights. But that's what I'm working on today. And as you may be able to see, I've got a wheelbarrow. It's got a little bit of mortar left in it. I'm going to basically work until I'm out of mortar today. And pretty back-breaking work, so I want to kind of space it out a little bit. But anyway, that's where I'm at right now. Like I said, we need to start on fencing for our cattle that we're going to run next year. And I want to work on a chicken tractor. I also want to experiment with a pig tractor or pig tiller, whatever you want to call it. basically the same concept as a chicken tractor, except it can house a pig. So I want to do that, and also a rabbit tractor. I'm really liking the idea of tractors whenever it's there's a lot of vegetation, so spring through fall. And there's other projects I've got to work on also, and things to do, upgrades, and yeah, just tons and tons of work. So hopefully you guys will stay tuned and watch what we have going on at the farm. So thanks for watching. God bless.